from those curious signals, I would suspect that England won the cup, won the toss. That is possibly anticipating things. It won the toss anyway, which is a start. And they will be playing in the left-hand goal, attacking the goal on your right. And the game is underway. The 1966 World Cup final has started. Bobby Moore. And a foul by Hodges in the first seconds of the game. Giving a free kick to England. Wilson to Moore. Wilson. And that ball still in play. Peters. Bobby Charlton. Peters. Bobby Charlton. Nobby Styles. Is he going to try one? George Cohen couldn't quite get a hold of that one. And Franz Beckenbauer. But Cohen will cut this one out. Peters. Peters. Bobby Charlton chasing in there. Peters. Oh, this is Haller for Germany. Zähler. Schnellinger. Held. Oh, this is Haller. A goal. A goal. Charlton, Bobby Charlton. Bobby Moore. Beckenbauer sticking close to Charlton. And Overath bringing down Moore. It's his second foul inside a minute and a half. Moore chipped down. Hurst, a chance, a goal! It's there! It's there! Skipper Bobby Moore, also of West Ham, and nodded a magnificent equaliser. The Germans were still waiting to set up a defensive wall. Moore. This is Hurst for England. Bobby Charlton. George Cohen. Peters moving forward. And Hurst going in under it. It's a good one! Across the box, and there's nobody there. What a great try by Hurst again. Chance for Overath. Emmerich must score. No. And now Moore for England. Peters to Moore. Hunt. That was a very badly directed ball. Emmerich and Moore having to cut across. Bobby Moore was England's hero right then, because Emmerich had a free run towards goal due to that badly directed pass from Roger Hunt. Now Alan Bell has George Cohen outside. Cohen. Ball. Bobby Charlton. Wilson. Hurst is under there. Hunt now with a great chance. Bobby Charlton. Ball. Beckenbauer lurking close to Charlton. This is Hurst. Chance for Charlton, pushed down in the box. Pushed down by Beckenbauer, and the referee waves play on as Tilkowski lies there. I don't think anybody touched him at all. In fact, nobody touched him. Well, defensively, I don't think anybody could fault Alan Ball. In the game as a forward, but what a lot of graft he gets through in defence. Bobby Charlton. Hunt. Good ball for Ball. Low. And Tilkowski had to put that away for a corner. Undoubtedly, when England dart in behind this defensive wall of Germany, they're getting them in trouble. Alan Ball with the corner for England. Hurst. And a chance here. Yes! It's Marty Peters! Marty Peters! There he is, Marty Peters! There's Alf Ramsey, looking a lot happier on his left. Harold Shepherdson, right on the far left, Les Cocker looking at his watch, wanting to see how much time left. Encouraging whistles from the crowd now, trying to encourage the Swiss referee to blow his whistle and stop this game, end this game. Oh! A foul against Jack Charlton. Referee Dienst is certainly not making a lot of friends amongst the England spectators here at Wembley. Now, Emmerich. Oh! It's there! It's the equaliser! And it's Weber, Wolfgang Weber. Disappointed he must feel there. England less than 15 seconds, I would say, from picking up the World Cup. There's disappointment on Nobby Stiles' face. Bobby Charlton shouting. Schnellinger. Germany surging forward. Aim for Zähler. England getting in their own way as they hurry to get rid of this ball. Alan Ball. And now we've got three Englishmen on Moscow left Alan Ball. Now Bobby Charlton for England. As the Germans slowly funnel back into defence. Jack Charlton, his brother, is making an overlap run down the left. And there he goes. This is a dangerous one. And again, Mr. Tilkowski is lying down, getting up as though he's badly hurt. In fact, Hurst, I don't think, got anywhere near him. This is Hunt to Ball. Charlton is there. This is Peters. Charlton. Oh, he hit the post! Alan Ball. And but we saw it, our stop frame. It is a goal. It is a goal. They've given it. It is a goal. Hurst is the scorer. Jeff Hurst, the scorer. Just about 1 minute of this game left now. This is Hunt. Trying to find Alan Hall and couldn't. And the Germans throwing every man into the England box now, trying to find just this one more goal that will force a replay. Bobby Moore, the referee, looking at his watch. The referee looking at his watch. Seconds ticking away as Martin Peters goes for, Jeff Hurst goes forward. He might make it three. He has! He has! And that's it! That's it! Whistle has not gone, the game's not over. He's still pointing to the centre of the field, I think. No. No, the game is over. Two linesmen have come on to the referee. The referee is looking anxiously as though he wants to restart the game. But England have won the World Cup, there's no doubt about that. 4-2. 4-2, it's all over. Number 16, Martin Peters, the scorer of England's second goal, Bobby Moore. There he is, Bobby Moore, going up the steps of the Royal Box to get the Jules Rimet World Cup trophy. The third time in 3 years he's picked up a cup at Wembley. The FA Cup 2 years ago, the European Cup Winners' Cup last year, and now the supreme prize of all, the Jules Rimet World Cup. There is Bobby Moore. Sir Stanley Rouse alongside Her Majesty the Queen, and there it is. That's what it's all been about. It's only 12 inches high. That is the supreme prize of the Jules Rimet World Cup trophy. Jeff Hurst, three goal, Bobby Moore, Roger Hunt, Martin Peters, the fellow who scored England's second goal, big Jack Charlton, what a great time he had, Ray Wilson tired, but what a fine play, Alan Ball, George Cohen, sound in this England, wonderful England fans, Nobby style, and Gordon Banks, a great, great performance by this England player. We've won the cup. Worth only £3,000, but it's the supreme prize in soccer. Dave, would you briefly like to say a word about England's performance at Wembley?
This is the greatest performance England have ever had in their history, as long as they've been playing football. It gladdens our hearts, everyone here, and it does wonders for us.